Let us see what is this question number 2 of chapter 6, Electromagnetic Induction. It says, use Lenz's law to determine the direction of induced current in the situations described by figure 6.19 A and B. Correct? Just see the figures A and B. Let us do one by one. In this case, your magnetic field, that is B, is cross. That means it is going inside the plane. Correct? Going inside the plane. Now, a wire of irregular shape turning into a circular shape. Now, this wire, once it starts turning into a circular shape, means its area, surface area, is basically increasing. And due to that, the magnetic flux crossing this loop perpendicular, that is also increasing. And because of this increase, there will be an induced EMF or induced current inside this coil, such that the magnetic field produced by this induced current must be opposite to what is the initial magnetic field, because it has to oppose, because area is increasing, magnetic flux is increasing. That means it must produce an induced current, or induced current should produce a dot magnetic field. For producing the dot magnetic field, what can be the direction? It has to be clockwise, correct? Sorry. So, for producing a dot magnetic field, dot magnetic field means it is coming out of the paper, perpendicular to the paper, coming out of the perpendicular to the paper. I hope you are aware of this cross magnetic field and dot magnetic field is a type of notation we use while defining the magnetic field, the direction. In the questions. So for producing dot magnetic field, the induced current must be anti-clockwise. Correct? It is the same thing as if the current is like this, then your magnetic field will be anti-clockwise. Or you have a loop where anti-clockwise, if you are seeing from above, anti-clockwise, and then your magnetic field will be like this. Correct? So it has to be, so means A, D, C, D, this way the current will move anti-clockwise. And here, in the figure B, what is happening? This circular coil or circular loop, you are pressing that. Means the area through which the magnetic flux is passing will be decreasing. So this loop will be experiencing a decrease in magnetic flux. Here the basically direction of the magnetic field is dot magnetic field, but since it is decreasing, so induced current, whatever induced current here it is developing, it must also produce a dot matrix magnetic field, because as per Lenz's law, it will try to oppose that decrease. I hope this is clear. And when it is trying to oppose that decrease, so whatever decrease is happening, it will try to support that or it will try to oppose that, correct? So for dot again, it has to be anti-clockwise, or you can say this will be like this. A dash, D dash, C dash, B dash. Correct? I hope this question is very clear. It's a very thoughtful question. Correct? Now we will go to the next question.